الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي وآله وصحبه. أما بعد، my dear brothers and sisters, my dear children, dear guests, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. In سورة المعارج, chapter 70, معارج means different ways of ascent into heaven. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions some of the negative attributes or the negative characteristics of man. And he gives us the solution how to improve on these things. Starting from verse 19, chapter 70. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الإنسان خلق هلوعا. So the word هلوع, the Arabic word هلوع, I'll give you different shades of the word from the Oxford Dictionary. هلوع is someone who feels so anxious. So many of us actually can get so anxious. You suffer from anxiety. It's a very well-known mental health issue. When you suffer from anxiety, something I've been suffering from for years, and I try to follow the remedies which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the same chapter to reduce its impact on my health. So halua, someone who's anxious, very worried, fearful, apprehensive, uneasy, agitated, nervous. I'm sure many of us suffer from this or from some of the things I have just mentioned. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what Allah is saying in this verse, man was created very impatient, very anxious, very worried because of the free will we have been given. If you had no free will, if you were like the angels, no free will, you wouldn't have suffered from any of these things. And also it is because we haven't got true faith. If we have really faith in Allah's wisdom and judgment and grace, we wouldn't have suffered from any of these things. Man, according to the plan of Allah, was to be in the best moods. خلق الإنسان سبحانه وتعالى في أحسن تقويم, the best mood. But in order to fulfill his high destiny, he was given free will to a limited extent. The wrong use of this free will makes his nature weak or hasty or impatient. That becomes his nature by his own act. But he is spoken of as so created because of the capacities given to him in his creation. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains or elaborates on the meaning of hala, this sort of worry or anxiety. He says, إِذَا مَسَّهُ الشَّرُّ جَزُوعًا. When evil touches him, he despairs. جَزُوعًا, again, different shades, distressed, upset, fretful, miserable, unsettled, agitated, distraught, despair. So when he receives bad news, how does he react? When a calamity hits him, what does he say? Does he question Allah? Or does he say, إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ لَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةَ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ الْعَلِيِّ الْعَظِيمِ اللَّهُمَّ أَجِرْنِي فِي مُصِيبَاتِي وَخْلُفْ لِي خَيْرًا مِنْهَا. Does he do that? Does he say that? Or does he become so depressed to the extent that he might start to take drugs or alcohol or maybe he commits suicide. There are people when they are so distressed or upset, unfortunately, it affects their mental status and then they might start to do something wrong. So when evil touches him, he becomes so distressed, so upset, so miserable. وَإِذَا مَسَّهُ الْخَيْرُ مَنُوعًا. But when good reaches him, he becomes so greedy and so miser and so stingy. He becomes so mean. He becomes ungenerous. The whole thing now is his. In adversity, he complains and gets into despair. In prosperity, he becomes arrogant and forgets other people's rights and his own shortcomings. This is you. It's very important. See, the only one who knows very well the weaknesses of us, the mental status of us, is the creator, is the maker. Like when someone produces a car, the car manufacturer knows exactly how does this car operate, what will happen if you put petrol instead of diesel, what will happen if you exceed the speed limit or the RPM on your clock. He knows this because he made the car. He knows the minute details of this car. In the same way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he knows our mental health issues. We all suffer from this. Every one of us. There is no exclusion, unfortunately. Give bad news to someone. Give him bad news. And see how is he going to react. And give him good news. And see the reaction. Unfortunately, we all fit into this description. Al-hala', al-jaza', and al-man'. We become anxious and worried, or we become distressed and upset, or we become mean and ungenerous and greedy. Yes, yes, we are. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his wisdom is saying to us, I know you can go through all this, but I will give you the remedy. I will give you a prescription which will help you during these difficult times or during the times of prosperity. When people walk away and forget about what they called Allah for before. A very interesting parable is given in Surah Yunus chapter 10. When people are traveling on a cruiser or in the middle of the ocean, beautiful weather, calm sea, you can see the sun rising, very favorable wind, and they think, وَظَنَّ أَهْلُهَا أَنَّهُمْ قَادِرُونَ عَلَيْهَا. And people thought they have full power and control over everything. Look at the size of the ship. Look at the experience of the captain. And then suddenly, wind comes from every direction. The waves are so high. And everyone now is asking for help. Everyone is screaming. They never believed in God before. Never. They never called upon him before. But now, at this moment, everyone is calling for God to help them, to save them. And Allah saves them. And they get back to the shore. And what happens? They forgot about it completely. As if they have never called upon him before. Maybe you are not well. And you keep praying. Please God, give me good health. Please God, make me recover. Please God, help me. And then he makes you recover. And you forget about it. And you walk away. And then Allah says, can't I bring them back into the sea again? Or I destroy the earth beneath their feet? Can't he make you unwell again? Can't he take your property back again from you? We need to understand this. You cannot just call upon Allah when you are in trouble and then when you are in prosperity, you forget about him. You forget about the poor and the needy. You don't even claim that the good you have is from him. You claim it is from your own self. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exempt from these horrible mental health problems illa al-musalleen. Subhanallah. إلا المصلين. إلا in Arabic means except. المصلين those who are devoted to prayer. Those when they have a problem, what they get up. They do their wudu or ghusl or purification and they go and they pray two rak'ah asking for help. He puts his head on the floor and he's asking for help. Devoted to prayer. In verse 153, chapter 2, Allah says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا who you believe, استعينوا بالصبر والصلاة. إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. Seek help in prayers and being patient. Prayers and being patient. When Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam gave the final speech in front of his brothers and parents, he said, إِنَّهُ مَنْ يَتَّقِي وَيَصْبِرْ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُضِيعُ أَجْرَ الْمُحْسِنِينَ إِنَّهُ مَنْ يَتَّقِي وَيَصْبِرْ. You have to be righteous and you have to be patient to overcome all your problems. You have a problem, go and pray. Wake up at night and pray. Increase the number of prayers. And instead of doing the compulsory 5 daily prayers, pray more. If you fear something. Prophet ﷺ used to do that. So let's rely on prayer. Firstly, let's maintain our 5 daily prayers. This is the first thing. Let's make sure that we are not missing them. You can join them, especially in winter now. Pray Dhuhr and Asr, Maghrib and Isha when you go home. Because the time is very, very short, 12 to 4. No excuse. No excuse. إلا المصلين الذين هم على صلاتهم دائمون. Not so those devoted to prayer, those who remain steadfast to their prayer. Verse 22 and 23, chapter 17. Yes, but I would like to overcome the rest of my concerns, my worries, my anxiety. I'm not going to chew a gum like the football manager. You see them watching a match and everybody's so anxious. Because he might lose his job if his team will not score. And you can see them chewing gum to absorb the anxiety. We have other ways of doing it. وَالَّذِينَ فِي أَمْوَالِهِمْ حَقٌّ مَعَ